The majority report has it that there was no, that there was ample reason to clear the executive secretary. What is the prevailing reason for that?
That was not part of the report.
So
the majority found that there was no evidence pointing to support a quantum of proof that. If you mention the executive, I'm not defending the executive secretary.
Sure, sure.
If there is evidence to point as to the culpability of the executive secretary, that we will sign that. But there was no evidence. If they can show an inkling of evidence that would point to the liability of the executive secretary, we will sign a report. But there was no evidence that can be pointed out. I'm not defending the executive secretary. I don't know him. I am defending the majority report.
Very clear. Senator Tolentino, also in the last hearing, the executive secretary was supposed to have confirmed or at least provided you with material.
Which hearing is this?
The last one. The last one before you terminated. The hearing when the executive secretary showed up.
You're referring to the sugar.
Yes.
Not to the laptop, yes.
Right. We're going to go into that later on. But first, let's focus on the views of the minority here. So in that last hearing...
We respect the views of the minority.
Yeah. In the last hearing, Senator Tolentino, there was a question about whether or not there was actually some people... in an online meeting, while there was a physical meeting between Mr. Serafica and E.S. Rodriguez, and he was supposed to get back to you on that. Has he gone back to you? Has he provided you with any more details regarding that?
I think I was the one who raised that question. The your records, the videos will show that. But before the end of the meeting, we were told that, in fact, there was no such meeting that took place. But while I mentioned that there might be some confidentiality that can be invoked involving legislative executive privileges, mm-mm, and the possibility of violating some data privacy act, mm-mm, it was clearly announced then that there was no such Zoom
component.
Yes.
Mm-mm. Okay, and what about the 600,000 metric ton idea allegedly coming from the president?
That was an allegation. That was an allegation. That was an allegation coming from, I think, Mr. Serafica. But there was no proof. It was not substantiated by any documentary or other testimonial evidence. That was a claim. A bare allegation is a mere claim, not having any anchor or leg in fact nor in law.
Which leads some viewers to think that
you can claim anything. You can claim 800,000, 900,000, but it has to be supported by facts. It was not substantiated, mm-hmm, corroborated by any other statement. It was just him. So we gave the minority the ample time to support that, but no evidence came up. In fact, it was the minority who moved for the issuance of the subpoena to the executive secretary, which we granted. Right. And they have all the time. They have all the time when the executive secretary was there to ask questions. Mm. To ask questions. So, I'm not against a minority report. It's part of the tradition, but again, the minority report is just a conglomeration of the views of the minority that would be part as an annex of the majority report.
Mm-mm. But to the thought that the hearing was prematurely terminated, what is your reaction to that?
No, it was the minority leader himself said that they have no more questions to ask.
And so therefore you moved to terminate.
This is the problem. The claims of premature termination, I don't think that would have a bearing, because in previous congresses, when you have long hearings, people would say it's been taking you so long, there is no end to this. But when you finish this, and as I promised, there is a roadmap, there's going to be an end to this, and in 48 hours we're able to submit a report, of course people will question again, how come it's too fast. When you're too fast, people question. When you're too slow, people would also question.
We hear you.
But the fact of the matter is, with that, we came up with the report.
Okay, we got you. Now, the series of actions of the Department of Agriculture Undersecretary Sebastian, SRA Administrator Serafica, board members Beltran and Valderrama had overwhelming badges of good faith. That's coming from the views of the two members of the minority. And yet in your report, we all know this by now, you recommended the filing of charges against these officials.
I've been studying law for the last several decades. This is the first time I heard of that term, badges of good faith. We all hear when you go to law school, you hear badges of fraud. But badges, there's no such thing as badges of good faith. But I don't quarrel with the report. So just read the 75-page report of the majority, compare it with the 17-page report of the minority. Mm-hmm.
Because that's the question right there. You have the majority report, the findings of the Blue Ribbon Committee. You have the views of...
The majority prevails.
Right.
In a democratic system, the majority prevails. We cannot satisfy the minority, but the records will show that they were given ample time to question, to participate. They were there. Mm-hmm. In fact, they were the ones who asked for, I mentioned this, for the presence of several witnesses.
Yes.
So we don't quarrel with that. Again, in a democratic system, the majority prevails.
Mm-hmm. But here's the situation that we have right now, Senator Tolentino. You have that report, you have the minority view. In the middle is the public. Because the reports are not exactly, I mean, it's magkasalungat po.
It will not match. It will not match.
Exactly.
It will never match.
Exactly. So my question
the prevailing report is the majority report. Mm-hmm. In any democratic system, the majority will prevail.
Yeah.
Even in elections.
So in the middle po kasi, yung publiko. So,
how can you claim that the public...
No, because there are, yung sinabi nyo na rin po, magkasalungat, hindi talaga magmamatch yan. So the question is, Senator Tolentino, what
no, no, no.
would
you, you
make...
No, you cannot claim that the public is in between. You cannot claim. Perhaps there are some sectors that have neutral views or fence-sitters, but again, the majority prevails. Mm-hmm. And this is based on factual... This has legal and factual basis.
So, ang sinasabi niyo po, the majority prevails and therefore the public should believe the report of the majority?
We're not saying that. Everything is based on law and evidence.
Mm.
Evidence. You cannot, inferences cannot be drawn from other inferences. Yun yung legal system. So, we have the rule of law to follow.
Mm-hmm.
It's not based on speculation. It should not be based on emotion, passion. It should be based on the spirit and the letter of the law.
Interesting that you mentioned the law and factual evidence. The minority report...
I'm a lawyer.
Exactly,
I know my law.
Opo, ito po ang sinasabi ng views ng minorya. They're saying that the recommendation of the filing of charges against these individuals are lacking in factual and legal basis. How do you then defend?
They have to prove that. They should have asked questions. They should have supplied us with the evidence. Those are mere allegations. They participated in the hearings. Mm-hmm. They were there. They should have supplied us with the proof. To enable us to reach that quantum of proof, that certainty that these persons are liable, this should be done. So they were allowed to submit. They have the burden to supply us with the evidence required. Mm. But we waited. Wala naman.
All
so
right.
mere allegations cannot stand.
Mm.
Of course, we respect their views.
Mm. Senator Tolentino, we saw the beginning of the Blue Ribbon Committee hearing on the sugar importation fiasco and also saw it through the end. You were very, very deliberate in your actions as you headed the Blue Ribbon Committee hearing. Very, very deliberate also in the ways and on how you handled it. But what do you say to what Senators Pimentel and Ontiveros said that during the hearing, these individuals were unfairly vilified in the proceedings, their careers tarnished because of how the hearing was conducted?
Who are you referring to?
Yung apat
because
po.
There is evidence of conspiracy, And I think you should read the report. I don't want to argue. Read the report. They will have their day in court. They will have their lawyers. They will be given due process. There's gonna be a due process. But I stand with the report signed by the majority. Conspiracy established based on several jurisprudence. So, ano pa ba yung kailangan? So, this will go through a judicial process where they will have their day in court to dispute allegations of violations of Republic Act 3019 and other special laws. Mm.
And talking about due process now, let's go to the other investigation, this time on the laptops.
You should clarify that. You should clarify that.
Alin po?
That this is not an inquisitorial proceeding. That what was done, this was done in aid of legislation.
Yeah.
The functions of the Blue Ribbon fully performed. So there's another step when you go to the judicial process.
Right. And that's very clear. In all of our coverages, that's what we always reiterate. Let's go to...
And it's very transparent, covered by live streaming, et cetera.
So let's go to the other inquiry now. When you mentioned due process,
which is ongoing, and I think we should not preempt, prejudge, and we should not, again, as I mentioned in the previous interview, we should not jump to any conclusion yet because it is still evolving. If there is such a thing as sub judice in a court, I think. We should have a semblance of that.
But still, I have to ask you this, and we have been covering it as well.
Yes.
When you talk about due process, do you think that was present in the actions of the Education Department? Even Senator Sherwin Gatchalian already said it was defective, the laptops.
If you're referring to the persons being investigated, I think the proper thing to do is to interview them. I will not be their lawyer. I am not lawyering for them. You should ask their positions or views whether the actions of the Blue Ribbon is in consonance with due process of law.
No, it's not about the Blue Ribbon Committee, but it was a due process whether
so you're
or not.
Asking my-
Whether or not it
view.
Was followed. Yeah, not exactly your view, because I know what you're going to answer there, but what is clear to you in the past, in the recent hearings, what is clear to you now? Was due process followed in the way they perfected the contract and procured and delivered?
There's a big difference between due process of law and procedural requirements in administrative procurements. Concerning Republic Act 9184. Due process would probably be a generalized term that should not be used often because this involves the purchasing of a laptop. So probably that's a misquoted term for a layman. So I think I would hold my opinion pending the conclusion of this investigation.
Okay, let me just go back to Christopher Lloyd Lau. In the beginning, he was saying, remember this, Senator, that he wasn't there anymore when all of this happened?
Tie it up with the previous hearing during the sugar hearing, wherein during that previous hearing when we denied, the Blue Ribbon Committee denied his request that his... whole departure order be lifted. So started with that.
Right. So do you now what can you tell the public about up to this point, yesterday's
still,
hearing?
We are still trying to piece the evidence. I know it's good to play Sherlock Holmes for every armchair general quasi lawyer, but we have to really connect the dots based on facts, evidence. There is such a thing as a quantum of proof required, and we're still tying this up all together. All the loose thing. I think this should not be treated just as a telenovela.
Seriously,
we are looking into this because you look at rights of people, you look at the amount involved, and you look at the consequences relative to the educational system. It was done during the previous DepEd administration. So the factum probandum should come out after the end of the hearings.
And we also should look at the hard work that the senators have put into precisely to help the teachers, to aid them in their teaching during the time of the pandemic, because that's at the very core of this issue. You worked hard so that they could procure the necessary equipment to aid their teaching.
And we're still exercising our oversight functions as we speak.
Mm-mm. All right. Now, how many more hearings before you wrap up the inquiry?
I don't know because what would happen, and you're familiar with this, is that when you're approaching the budget hearings, it will be tied up with other hearings as well as we're looking at the availability of even some of the members of the Blue Ribbon Committee as well as the rooms available. So all of this will have to be taken into consideration. But I am pretty sure that I will end this. Just like as my previous promise that I will end that sugar fiasco hearing, there will be a definitive conclusion to this.
Mm-hmm. And as you move towards that, what are the important questions that still need to be answered before you wrap up this inquiry into the laptops procurement?
Like your news report, whether there was an accurate date of the notarization, when the MOA was signed, I would think that would be outcome determinative insofar as the hearing is concerned. Mm-hmm. So we're still trying to, again, piece all of this together, and you will have the report. And again, I'm sure there will be a minority report again to this. So you will have the report, and that's democracy.
Mm. All right. We're going to have to leave it at that. Blue Ribbon Committee Chair, Senator Francis Tolentino there joining us this noon. Really appreciate it. Thanks again.